Hey folks, I'm Dieter Melhorn. In this video, I'm going to give you 5 tactics to keep in mind for catching flathead catfish. Folks, if you fish for catfish, you probably really like to catch flathead catfish. They're one of the most popular catfish for folks to catch. Why is that? Well, one, they're very elusive. They're not readily abundant in most waterways. They're not a fish that you're going to catch 25 or 30 of in most lakes and rivers. The other thing is they get really large, much bigger than the channel catfish and bullhead. So they're a big fish. They have a massive mouth on them. They just look like a fish eating machine. They are an apex predator and they look like it. The shape of them is amazing too. From the side, they look big. From the top, looking at them across their back, they look even bigger. They look massive. So they are an awesome fish. And the other thing is, when you get one right next to the boat after fighting it, it's not done. They're usually gonna make a dive and make a run right there at the boat. So just when you think the fight's over and you're getting ready to put it in the net, they're usually taking off again. So all of these things make flathead catfish one of the most prized possessions in the catfish world. Now, catching these things in most places can be tough. It takes some special tactics and things to do and things to keep in mind when you're pursuing them. And I'm going to go over a few of them. Not all of them, but 5 big things, especially for you guys that are starting out chasing these fish, to keep in mind when you're trying to catch flatheads. It's some little tips, little things. Some of you know, some of you may not know. And one of the things I've learned from doing guide trips recently is that a lot of things that I take for granted people know, new anglers, people who are just getting into the sport, or somebody that just decides, I want to catch flatheads instead of channels and blues, doesn't quite realize. So I'm going to take the time to break some of this stuff down to a little simpler terms, a little of the basics, I guess you will, and hopefully it'll help you guys put a few more fish in the boat. Now, one of the first things that you're going to hear from anybody who talks about flathead catfish is you got to fish at night. You got to fish in the dark. It's the only time to catch flatheads is at night. They just feed at night. It's not true, first of all. You can catch flatheads during the day. You can catch them during the daylight. As a matter of fact, I'm sitting here thinking back. I know my first flathead over 50 pounds came during the day. I know my second one did. And I'm thinking my third one did too. Most of my flatheads have come during the day. Now, with that said, I fish more during the day, so obviously I'm gonna be apt to catch more. But even going out at night, the numbers and the percentages are just not overwhelmingly favoring fishing at night. Now, with that said, I do prefer to fish for them at night, not so much because of when they're feeding, but because of the time of the year that I generally pursue flathead catfish, and that is the summertime, the warmer months. Especially the trophy flatheads. And it's easier, one, to be on the water when it's cooler, and two, it's easier to be out there just because of boat traffic, especially if you're on a congested lake like I'm on. Just the boat traffic is a lot nicer in those wee hours. Now, generally for me, I find that the better flathead bite is in the hours just before daylight. Believe it or not, getting out there right at dark at 9 o'clock for me is generally not a good idea. I will do it sometimes, but I would much rather wait until about 11 o'clock at night, a couple hours after dark, to actually go out. You can go out right at dark. That's fine. It helps with navigation and seeing. Maybe you want to catch bait. Maybe you just want to get out there then. But in our area especially, we got a lot of boat traffic still on the lake then, and it is like things need to settle down some. So what I'll do a lot of times is I will get out there later and fish more of that midnight range, so about 2-3 in the morning. That seems to pay off better than being there right at dark. Now, with that said, I will also get out there at about 4 in the morning and fish about a 4 to 5 hour period, that 2-3 hours before sunrise and then 2 to 3 hours after sunrise. That seems to be a sweet time for putting flatheads in the boat. Now, you have probably heard that you need to fish structure to catch flatheads. And honestly, for me, that is where I've had most of my luck. I try to find areas that have some type of something in the water. That's what we mean by structure, something in the water that is different. It can be trees. It can be a rock pile. It can be an old bridge, debris. It can be a sunken boat. It can be an old barge that's underwater. Pretty much anything that offers something different besides that flat bottom. What this does is, one, it provides a place for flatheads to hide and stage up and ambush prey. In the same breath, it also provides a place for fish to congregate and hang around. The biggest example I can think of to equate it to human terms, if you're riding down the road and there's this huge, massive field, and you look out across that field, it all looks kind of just the same, except for that clump of trees out there in the middle, a small little two or three trees, maybe it's just one tree. Pretty much every bit of life will be seen around that clump of trees, whether it be birds, deer, cows, whatever. It's kind of the same thing out there in a big waterway. You know, most waterways are not covered and littered with a lot of stuff. But when you get those little concentrations of stuff, it brings in a lot of everything, and it's a good place to target to try to find these flatheads. Now, one of the other things you're going to hear is you got to use live bait. You got to use live bait for flatheads. You got to use live bait for flatheads at night. Not necessarily. Depending on where you fish, there may be some areas that live baits do work better. Live baits do provide action. Live baits do provide noise. With that said, a lot of our fish here in the southeast, our flatheads, are caught on cut bait. Why is that? I don't know. Is it just that's the way we fish and it works? Could be. Is it the fact that a lot of our live baits get killed by channel cats very quickly after being in the water? That could be part of it too. It's one thing that we see a lot in our reservoirs is when you put out live baits, channel cats are notorious for coming up, hitting them, crushing them. You can see the bite marks on them and never taking the bait. They don't even swim off with it. It's just like they want to kill it to get rid of it. So that's what ends up happening to a lot of our baits. Consequently, we end up using, you know, turning them into cut bait, and we do catch fish on them. It doesn't hurt. Usually what I do, in all honesty, is I put out about half and half. I will put out cut bait and I will put out live bait, about an even split. However, probably 90% of the flatheads I catch end up coming off of the cut bait. I have tried this anchored. I have tried it drifting areas, especially channel edges, rocky areas, points, that kind of things, trying to catch flatheads. Still, the overwhelming majority of them come on cut bait. But I do suggest to mix it up. You never know, especially if you're in an area with big blues, you may hook into a monster blue cat on that live bait. So it doesn't hurt to have them out. You know, the majority of the fish that these giant catfish eat are alive anyway, so you would think that would help. What happens with cut bait is, because it's cut open, because there's blood, because these juices are in the water, it provides more scent than a live fish does. Live fish, you're kind of relying on the action of the fish, movement of the fish, to bring in the feeding fish. Sometimes that happens, sometimes it doesn't. Depending on the fish, sometimes the fish get down there and just go dormant or just laid on the bottom. And you don't get really any bang for the buck out of them. But when you've got the scent out there, it's spreading scent, especially if you've got some current. So try both, but don't be surprised if you catch more on the cut bait. Now, one suggestion I make is to, if you're targeting trophy flatheads, don't fish until after July 4th. There's an old saying that between Memorial Day and July 4th, don't go fishing for catfish. And it's somewhat true. You can still catch good fish during that time period. But the general rule is, by July 4th, the catfish spawn is over. And these bigger fish are starting to feed, starting to prowl, and starting to stage up again. So, if you're able to pick your time, it's a good time to start targeting them. Now, we catch them in April. It's a pretty consistent bite for them. April going into May, and it's a good time to target some of the fish coming out of somewhat of their hibernation. They don't really hibernate, but they're very inactive. But once that water temperature starts to get 60 and above, that April-May time frame is a good time to catch flatheads. But there is kind of that mid-May through June where it gets bad. So if you got to pick your time, pick it after July 4th into about October, or go chasing them in that April to mid-May time frame. Now, one of the questions I get from people that watch some of my night fishing videos is they're asking about the illumination on the boat. I have a green light that's in the water. It's made by Lumisea. It is designed to attract bait fish. What it's actually doing is attracting plankton. Plankton brings in the bait fish, and other fish, predator fish, come in to eat those bait fish. I run that light. My thinking is this. My lines are cast out past where that green light is. I feel that bringing in those bait fish, whether it be crappie, white perch, whatever fish are coming to feed on those bait fish, even bass, white bass, it creates activity in the water. Activity in the water, fish can sense it. When other fish are feeding, they can sense it. And I think that attracts some of the bigger predator fish like flathead catfish. And they are out in the fringes of that area. I don't fish directly underneath the light. I'm out in the fringes where the light doesn't even penetrate. But I feel like those fish are out there. I've had it out for a couple of years now, and I've caught a lot of fish, a lot of good fish around it, at about or slightly better catch rates than what I had before I was using it. So I have no problem with running a light from the boat. Now, I will say this for bank fishermen. It's a little different animal because a lot of times the flathead that you're trying to catch may be a few feet out in front of you. I always say when you're fishing for flatheads, that area right along the bank in front of you that most people are throwing past is probably where a lot of those flatheads are. It's an area that a lot of us guys in the boat are actually casting over to. So you may want to be a little more cautious there right on the bank with your lights and what you're doing with your lights right around your rods, especially when it comes to the fish. You walk in between the light and the fish and they see something move in front of that light. They may sense that, hey, that may be a heron up there getting ready to peck me out of the water, and it drives them or runs them off. So a little caution like that on the bank with the lights. But when you're on the boat, I really do not think it causes a problem. Well, folks, if you made it this far, thank you for watching. Here are a couple more videos that I think you're going to like. I'd watch that one and then that one. No, do that one first and then that one. I don't know. Just watch them both. They're both good.